Hello, my name is Martijn van Groningen. I work for CertWorkings. I am a Lucene committer and PMC member, and I'm going to talk about joining in Lucene. My talk is based on the talk I gave in Lucene Revolution. Only now I have 20 minutes, so I'm not going to talk about result grouping. And questions can be asked at the end. So, small introduction. Data is often relational, but the Lucene document model is not. Users, they want good free text search over their data, but their data is usually relational. There are many solutions to tackle this, and one of them is to use the Lucene's joining support. Joining can be a bit of a misguiding name, because when people think about joining, they think about relational databases, think about SQL join. Well, that is something that's not implemented in Lucene. It's more a parent-child-like join. There are two types of joins. There is a index time join and a query time join. During the index time join basically defines the relation at index time, and the query time join, the relation is defined at query time. So let's go into index time joining. The index time joining support basically consists out of like two queries and one Lucene collector. The first query is called the two parent block join query. It's maybe a bit of a long name, but it explains actually what it does. Basically, it allows you to query for the children and return the parent documents as result. And the other query, the two child block join query, allows you to query on the parent and get the children back as result. These two queries either return parents or children document hits, and the collector enhances this by basically allowing you to have like a relation hit per result. So having the parent and the matching children as result in the same hit. I have an extra slide about this at the end. I hope I get there. So then I can explain it a bit more. But I will focus on the queries. But more importantly, the index time joining, it relies on block indexing. And what is block indexing? Block indexing basically allows you to add documents in a specific order in the index. Normally, when you add documents to the index, the exact order it's being put in the index, you don't have control over. Block indexing will give you control over over the order where it's added to the index. Basically, it allows you to specify a list and add this list of Lucene documents to the index. And the order inside the list will define the order how it's being indexed. And each document will get a sequentially assigned Lucene document ID. So block indexing guarantees some kind of an order. And this is where the index time joining relies on, and it's built around it. So, something more about block indexing. These blocks of documents added to the index itself doesn't know about it. Documents just happen to be added in a specific order in the index, and that is all. So, the application using Lucene is in charge of basically keeping track of these blocks, but somehow marking the documents inside the block. Segment merging will not reorder documents inside a segment. So when segment merges, your block is safe. Removing documents from a segment will also not destroy your blocks unless you remove the parent. That will be a bit tricky. But the big downside of block indexing, if you want to add a document to a block, so to a relation, you basically have to re-index the whole relation. So that's at the same time the big downside. To get a bit more practical, I will start with a domain example, which is, I think, a classic e-commerce domain example with a product with some generic description and a product item which describes the variance and the price. So the goal is usually to show the most applicable product based on some user query on product data and some specific filters on the product item level. So usually product and product items are stored separately. And the challenge is how to index it and how to search it. So if we are going to index this in a block, it will basically look like this. So we have separate documents for each product item and product, and they are added in a block. It's very important that the last document added to the block is the parent. So in our case, the product item or the product, sorry, the product document, and before that, and all the product items belonging to that product. And this is then indexed as a block, for example. You can have more blocks with more product items and products, but you will just append them so in the specific order. But the parent should always be last. So if we take a look at some code, it will basically look like this. These are factory methods that basically create a product and a product item. The reason why I'm showing this, because I will be marking the product document. So all products have a special field doc type with value product. This way, the index time join can recognize the parents. And for the product item, we don't do anything. This is 4.0 API. If you do this something similar in 3.x, it's similar but different. And then we'll add the documents to the index. So basically, we have we create an index writer. We create a list, and in this list we add the documents. We start with the product items, and then we'll add the last one. We add the product, and basically we'll store this whole list to the index writer. And there is a special method for that called addDocuments, in plural, and it accepts a list. And in that particular order, the documents are stored in the index. And then we can add another list of product items and product and continue till we are done. When we're done, we instantiate a index reader and a index searcher. And then we can do searching. And that is the next part. Am I going too fast or is that okay? Okay. So the query part. So this is an example of how to use the two-parent block join query. We start with the filter because we need to identify the parent documents. And we did that during indexing. So now we have to do it during searching so that the two-parent block join query also knows this. So we create basically a query. We wrap it in a filter. And this will be used as input to the two-parent block join query. Then we create a query in where we select specific product items. In this case, we want everything with size medium, and all the other product items we are not interested in. When we define that, we define a score mode. The score mode is actually very important because when you have multiple product items, one product, so multiple children for a parent, and you need to define how you map the child scores into the parent. There are various options for that. This option, for example, max, basically selects the highest score, highest child score, and that's mapped into the parent. But there are also other options like average, total, sum, sending twice, and none. But you can select that. You basically construct a main query where you fill in the user query. The user query is something, for example, to search for a specific product description. And to that query, we also add the two-parent block join query. And then we can actually execute the search. So in this case, although the product items and product are different documents, we only get back the products that have product items with size medium. And that's what we will get back in the top docs as result. As you see, there's quite some code involved to do this. Luckily, there is an out-of-the-box solution that you can use. Elasticsearch has block join support. It's called differently. It's called a nested query in Elasticsearch. But you know, if you have you have to do some work and you get it work, and this will just make it easier for you. basically, you can define a nested type inside your mapping. And basically, you can independently then query on these nested types and get back the root object as result. So that's basically what it does. But under the hood, it uses the two-parent block join query. So it's something you, if you want some out-of-the-box solution, then it's something you can take a look at. So let's take a look into query time joining. Query time joining is actually is a different implementation of joining. It is field-based. It doesn't rely on block indexing. So you can just index your documents as you would do normally. Doesn't matter the specific order. And the search under the hood is basically executed in two phases. Basically, when you do a search, a join search, there is a first phase in where you basically search, you have a user query, and you collect all the from values matching with the user query are collected. Then those values are used in the second phase to match documents of a different type that have the same value in a different in the two fields, and that's how the result is returned. And basically, there's only one public API for this, a public method for this to do this, and that's it's a static method called create join query. So if we are going to use the join query, it will look like this. Indexing is different, of course. The only thing that's different is that in a product item, you have a field that just points to a product. That's basically, if you're using SQL, that's what you usually do. You point to a different type, right? So that's what you do here as well. And you can just index documents with the normal index writer methods. You can add in any specific order, or any arbitrary order, sorry. And when you've done that, you can basically use it. You have a you define a from field, a from query. In our case, we only want product items from price 0 to 1,000. You define a score mode and the to field. And basically, this is the main input for this static method. The query that's created, you will just add to your main query, and you will get back documents matching the user query plus having product items only in this price range. And it turns out that in this case, it's only one document because only product one has product items in this price range. The query time joining also allows you to do a join across indexes. One of the input arguments for the create join query is to specify a from searcher, and that defines where you get the values from, which are then used in the second index to basically match documents. In this case, I used score mode.none, meaning I don't care about scoring, and it's also not done. It's not computed. In this case, it doesn't matter because you either want price documents matching this price range or not. So why do you want scoring? So that's also very important to know that if you don't care about scoring, don't use it. It will save you computation time. The score mode the another option you can specify here is multiple values per doc, meaning that sometimes documents can point to more than one document and can be referred to by more than one document. In this case, you have multiple values per field, and it means that there's a different implementation is chosen to do the joining, which is less efficient but gives you correct results. If that's not the case, then set it to false. Also, in the example I gave, there's only one value per document, so it should be set to false for the right performance. Okay, to sum it up, joining module has good solutions for to basically have a parent-child-like joint. There are situations where you have maybe, if you, where the relation is maybe complex. If you compare it, let's say you have a five inner join SQL query. Well, I wouldn't map it to this. I would design it right when indexing and try to model it in the parent-child model. Also, you can with the query with the index time join, you can have a grandparent, a parent, and a child structure. So, if you can model it something like that, it will be it will work. It will work also performantly. However, it's also always to remember that joining has impact on query time. Nothing is for free. There to say that index time joining is much faster than query time joining, but it's also less flexible than query time joining. And to give you rough numbers, it's I think it's between 3 to 5 times faster index time joining compared to query time joining. Although query time joining gives really good performance. For example, on a few, let's say if 10 million documents, which I usually use from a test data set, it means that it will give you results below 400 milliseconds, depending on how many terms, or how many documents you've matched, the number of relations you have, etc. and of course, if what the score mode you're using, etc. Most of this is a Lucene feature. All code is yet marked as experimental, so APIs can change. Yeah, so this is basically my fast talk. I have one extra slide left, but I think now it's time for questions. So if anyone has questions, shoot. Yeah?
I think for query time joining, you have to get all the field values of your HIT documents, and this can be quite time-consuming.
Sorry?
You have, for query time joining, you have to get all values of your field for all HIT documents.
Yes, for all documents that matched.
Yeah. Do you use something like field cache or something similar so that the values are already in memory?
Initially, yeah, yes. Field cache is used to retrieve the values from, yeah.
Okay.
Solar.
Oh, from Solar has a join, but it is not used right now. Not using the Lucene implementation. It has its own implementation, but it can be used. Yeah. It's called the Solar join. If you look it up, it's, you get a hit in a wiki, and then you can use it.
So can I optimize my indices when I make this indexing time joins, because during index optimization, the ID numbers are lost, isn't it?
Sorry, I didn't get your question. Sorry.
So for the index optimization, when you optimize your index with the index writer, then the document number IDs, the document ID numbers are gone. Is then the whole index broken when I optimize my index?
For index time joining or query time joining?
For index time joining, because I have to make this block document block.
Yeah, well, it doesn't rely on the specific Lucene IDs, but it relies on the order of the documents. But the order is preserved during merging.
Okay.
So it doesn't rely on the number, but the order.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Then I go to the extra slide. So I talked about the two-parent block join query. Now I'll talk about the collector. Basically, it allows you to collect the children that have matched with its parent. And therefore, you can give a combined view. For example, in this case of products and product items, it's really interesting to also have the product item as part of your result so that you can show that to the user in one search instead of doing subsequent searches. So you cannot use the normal search method, but you need to use the search method that allows you to specify a Lucene collector. First, you define a sort on how you want to sort basically the parents and the number of parents you want to return. You execute search, and then secondly, you define to sort within the children. So it's really interesting to sort by price, so you can show the user the cheapest price. Then you can define how many children you would like to return. Usually the user is only interested in the cheapest price, of course, so it can be one. And then you return, you get back a top groups, which basically is a grouped view of your hit, so your parent and your first child. And you can then show that to the user, and you have like a joint view of your result. So it's really interesting, and many people want this kind of a joint view. And it's possible to use that, of course, now right now only from Lucene. I don't know any Solr or Elasticsearch are not using this class yet, but that's really an interesting a feature to be used. So, this was my last slide, and I think I made it in 20 minutes, right? Yeah. Yeah? Okay.